Now we'll show how you can download data for your GIS program from geoportals. The geoportal we are going to use, that is named Overpass Turbo. Search overpassturbo.com. overpassturbo.eu. Then search the area. Now we will search for the buildings. To search it, go to the wizard, search building. Then build and run query. Now you have to select the area. Go to the export. Go to the manually select box. Now go to export, download copy as JSON file, save it in your local folder where you are working. Give it a name. I name it the name, area name, and the building. Save. Now the file is saved. Now how you can open it in your QGIS? Just open your QGIS file. Open a new QGIS file. A new project. Go to add vector layer. Go to file. Search for the file which download. It was a JSON file. This one. Open. Add. No, it's added. Close. Now the file is looking skewed. Go to the PSG. Go to the. Go here. Then select the UTM zone 32. And apply. Okay. UTM 32 works for Germany. So I just selected it. Now it has some extra building than my any required area. So I will fix the area I need. To do that, I just go to the grid, go to the vector creation, create grid. just horizontal spacing particle spacing kilometer and grid type polygon, rectangle polygon, grid extent, use extent on canvas, no, draw a random extent, done. Close. Here it's 1 kilometer by 1 kilometer. Now click on the grid, select on the polygon, check the snap button, I'm just drawing a rectangle manually. I'll delete the grid, right click, give random ID any number. Make the layer power. Okay. Now change the symbology. Make it just outline, because I can see the buildings. And move it little bit. I think I need just this area. This is fair enough for me. This button will help you to move. Now we'll clip it. To clip this, we have to go to vector, geoprocessing, clip, select the input layer as the buildings and overlay layer as the grid, then run. It's clipped. Okay. Now I can delete this file, or you can just, I think it's better you can delete it. And now the now we'll calculate the area. To calculate area, we have to create a attribute table. We have to open attribute table. There is a lot of attributes. It's came from the overpass itself. We'll just use a new one, activate the layer, open field calculator, create new field, output field area, built area, it should be decimal number. Output field in precision 2, output field 10, or you can reduce it, then 2. Then go to the geometry, dollar sign area, double click on it, that's all. Okay, now at the very end you will see a new built area has been created. Here there is the area for all fields, all buildings here. Now you have to, you want to calculate it, the sum of this. To do that, just select the merge. Sorry, you have to select the area first. To go to the select button, click select, select the layer, then select all the buildings, then click on merge selected, then everything will be merged. When it is merged, a new field will be open there very soon. It's open. Yeah, it's opened. Now under the built area, click on the sum. Go down, go down. Click on the sum. Then, okay. Something happened, it missed. Now there is no only one table, one row, and the total build area is I need to check the unit. Let me check the unit. Project properties, go to the general, it's meter, need for distance meter and square meter. Nice. Okay, now go to the attribute table. Okay. 147,450.93. Okay. No, open a general calculator anywhere. Copy. Divide. 3, 4, 5, 6. So 0.147. Divide 100, so we'll get the percentage. Sorry, into 100. 0.147. Okay. 14.7. So this is our district coverage. 14.7. Okay, now let's just print it. Before print, let's change the color. Open attribute table. Oh, make the layer permanent. Make permanent. To permanent, you have to save it in your save it in your folder. Then okay, now it's the permanent layer. Now just change the color to give it a name. Built area. Properties, change the color to black. print, new print layout, name it figure ground map. And the map. So get the map size bigger. First of all, set the boundary, then click here is the move item content. Now I can move the content properly. Okay. I don't want this blue line here. Go to my QGIS. Switch off my grid. Now it's okay. Refresh, it's gone. Now just add a name, go to the add item, add level, name it figure ground map. Go to the font, select the font Lato. You can choose any font. I'm just choosing Lato and give the size 20. Okay. And give it color. Another item, district ground coverage equal, we calculated 14.7. Keep the font 16. Add item scale bar. Increase the scale. Change the color. North arrow. Now add some shapes. it pasted below. Now give the map a name. Tusk 1.